Well, let's continue on our coverage of the elections in Bayelsa and Kogi State. And our correspondent Uche Okoro joins me now from Bayelsa. Uche, now we see that you are at the venue of the collation center. How soon is the collation of results likely to begin, and when will a clear winner be announced?
Well, we do not know. I'll answer your second question. We do not know when results will be announced. But what I can tell you is that INEC has said that right in this hall, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., the exercise would commence. So far, it's been largely peaceful in Bayelsa State. Of course, there were a few areas where our materials arrived late, but by and large, generally, it's been quite successful in Bayelsa State. At least that's coming from the INEC officials. But they are saying that right now, they're preparing this hall for collation to commence tomorrow at 10 a.m. I have with me here the head of public education here and information in the INEC office here in Bayelsa State. I'll ask him a few questions to give us an update. Thank you so much for joining us, sir.
Thank you and good evening.
All right, sir, can you just give us an update on the status of the election in Bayelsa State as regards collation, sir?
All right, I think as far as collation is concerned, the election has been done and it took place in all the local government areas we have in Bayelsa State. And because, just like the Resident Electoral Commissioner explained, not quite long, and because of our topography and the challenge they will have in getting to this place in good time for the collection to be done, we are yet to have some of them coming from the local government level to be here. Although some of them are on their way, but looking at the time and probably the stress faced by all officials involved in the process, the REG did announce that by tomorrow, by 10 o'clock, the collation will commence.
And people would like to know if any results at all from any of the 8 local government areas have arrived. Also, you mentioned that some of your personnel are yet to arrive in Yenegua. So, are they stranded or it's late for them to travel?
Well, I won't say they are really stranded, but you know, for those of them coming along the waterways, you know, there's this restriction of time for boats to move on the waterways. I think from 6 p.m. So in order for us not to breach such and this thing, and for their safety as well, wherever they are now, they just have to remain, and by the next day, they'll be escorted down to Yenagua.
Okay, can you kindly share with us the modalities for tomorrow's collation? What's going to be the process? What's going to be the step one, step two? What kind of persons will be allowed into the compound or into this hall? So just share that with us.
All right, I think we have various stakeholders actually following the process for the collation. We have the party agents themselves. We have the observers, we have the electoral officers, and the collation officers also coming from the field that will watch the process. And of course, the INEC team that will be here to watch it. So as soon as they arrive from the local government area, it's expected that the electoral officer will come along with the collation officer for each of the local government area. They're expected to sit, introduce themselves, and give us a brief of what they have done and the local government area where they carry out their duty. And of course, they will now read out the figures scored for each of the participating parties in the election and to the hearing of everyone. Of course, it will also be projected so that everybody can see the scores as it's being entered.
So what kind of persons would be, is it a free-for-all? Is access going to be restricted?
Oh, no. As we speak, you know, already we have accredited media, that's the journalists now that we hear, already accredited. Then for the observers, already accredited. Then for the parties, 45 of them, their names are already with us for those that will represent them at the state level. So it's not a free-for-all for everything. Moreover, the hall we are using cannot just take everyone. So we have restrictions on those that will come in. But however, everyone will get to see whatever is being announced from this hall tomorrow. But although some of the observers, the overflow, will have an arrangement for them, a makeshift arrangement outside the hall, where they can also follow proceedings taking place inside the hall.
All right, now, lastly from me, before I let you go, sir, tonight, when, from your overview of things so far, how soon do you think final results will be announced? From your overview and your assessment of things on ground right now, can you say, can you project a time when we expect this to all come to an end?
Well, let's leave projection out. If I were to go by our own arrangement, I would say, okay, by today we should be having our results. But then, Bayelsa has its own peculiar topography, so you cannot tell. So let's see how tomorrow will be. We hope maybe before the day runs out, maybe the new results should be announced.
All right, thank you so much,
sir.
Thank
you very much.
All right, now that's the head of voter education and enlightenment here at the INEC headquarters in Yenagoa, state headquarters, that is, who has told us that tomorrow 10 a.m. for certain. Collation will commence right in this hall. Access will not be granted to all and sundry. Access will be restricted to only accredited personnel. So we are here. We're most likely going to pass the night here, so we don't miss any bit of the action, you know, to bring, of course, every bit of information to our viewers on TVC News.
And we will keep a close tab with you, our correspondent, Uchiukuru, live for us from Yonaguwa, Bayelsa State.